The first couple of days of May giving farmers plenty of nice weather to make some good progress on a large scale across Ohio. But a lot of seed companies are farming on a smaller scale, including here at Seed Consultants, their plot in Ross County. Had a chance to catch up with Matt Hutchison with Seed Consultants about what's going on behind me.
So we're here at our replicated plot location in Chillicothe, planting a corn plot today. This is one of 15 replicated locations we have in the state of Ohio. This is where we do our yield testing. We use these plots to take agronomic notes. We have some demo plots in here where we tear ears apart, look at kernel size, kernel depth, cob color, things like that. But this is basically what we use for placement of products on our customers' farms in differing soil types and growing situations, as well as advancing new products in the future.
He's dumping the varieties in for each range.
Pretty quick process.
Yes, it is. We're going 2.7 miles an hour. We're getting about 10 plots a minute.
Many of your customers have a little bit bigger equipment than this. They're able to do some acres in a little bit quicker time. This is a little bit of a tedious process, a four-row planter and all these small envelopes. Explain to us the process we're seeing behind us.
So we plant these plots. They're two rows, 20 feet long. We've counted out enough seed in the envelopes to plant a little beyond that 20 feet, and then we till out a 5-foot alleyway between each range. It is a time-consuming process to package this, and most of our plots are around 2 to 3 acres, and it may take us an hour and a half to 2 hours to plant. So it is fairly tedious, but it's a really important part of our company in terms of being a regional testing company and looking at products that work here for our customers and in the Eastern Corn Belt.
You mentioned your products, but there are some third parties that come out here and help you out with some of these projects as well.
That's right. In addition to our own tests, we have some third-party tests, whether it's Southwest Ohio Corn Growers or Integrated Ag. We also do some co-op testing for some foundation companies. So it's primarily our stuff, but we are helping out some other companies in terms of testing.
2017 was an interesting year. What is one thing, or maybe a couple of things, that you learned last year in these plots you were able to share with your growers at the winter meetings that they might be utilizing here to begin 2018?
2017, I think a lot of people remember we had a stretch of about a week of warm weather where we had favorable field conditions, and then that was followed by a cold snap with a lot of rain. And we learned last year not to plant right before that wet, cold weather. And so we've got pretty good forecast right now, but with some rain in the future, I think it's important to keep in mind you don't want to plant right before that rain. And we saw that in our customer fields and also in our plots. Try to avoid planting right before a cold, wet rain event because you could end up with cold shock to the seeds and end up with a poor stand that may need to be replanted.
Over the next 90 minutes here in this Ross County field, they'll have sown 2.3 acres of corn, 720 different varieties. We'll find out the results, of course, this fall. For the Ohio AgNet, I'm Ty Higgins reporting. We'll see you down the road.